imagine destination is Windsor Castle in Windsor, Berkshire County, United Kingdom. You will find an imposing castle that sits on 13 acres of impeccably manicured grounds and paths, home to over 39 monarchs for 1,000 years. Queen Elizabeth II being the current owner. Today, you are invited as a guest of the Queen to join her at a state banquet in Windsor Castle. Here, you are escorted to the sumptuously resplendent St. George's Hall. You pass through the massive, intricately carved, arched doorway, and you are given your first glimpse of the grandeur before you. Looking up, 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 your eyes travel over the tunnel vaulted ceiling with a multitude of brilliantly colored coat of arms. These are equally spaced between the interlocking arched green oak beams. You are greeted cordially by an attendant in sharp livery. He leads you forward down the never-ending, sparkling row of Baroque-style gold gilt plush chairs, passing by large oil portraits, marble busts of historical figures, and the many soaring arched windows which throw beams of sunshine across the tableau and sets the plethora of gold on the table ablaze. One of the center pieces is a 4 foot high gold candelabra with 12 flames, the base depicting Saint George battling a dragon. There is a veritable hothouse of cut roses in cascading arrangements decorating the table on tall gold pedestals. Flanking either side of this great hall are raised platforms with many silver suits of armor standing guard over this ostentatious event. Finally, seated, you absorb the splendor before you. There is a crystal array of drinking glasses, a champagne glass for the toast, a red wine and white wine glass, a water goblet, champagne glass for dessert, and one for after dinner port. A uniquely folded napkin graces your plate, folded impeccably by one man, all 170. The pattern is called a Dutch bonnet, and each one displays the Queen's hand-embroidered monogram in exactly the same position. A small gold gilt dish contains butter pats that have been chilled, sliced into discs, and imprinted with the royal crest. The table on which this feast is about to begin is made of a dark, rich mahogany and has a highly polished shine. It was made in 1846 and has 68 leaves. The silver platters, plates, centerpieces, candelabra, and special serving utensils, which there are 8,000 pieces. Take 8 people to hand wash, polish, and dry. It takes 2 days to set this table, placing 2,000 pieces of cutlery and 960 glasses. The position of each item on the table is precisely measured out. Even the chairs are spaced exactly 27 inches from the table. You draw your eyes away from the table and take in the elegantly dressed dignitaries, all seated, and the general hum of conversation begins. The last to be seated are the Queen and Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, at the head of the table. The meal will commence once they start their meal. The first course and the meat course are served on steaming silver gilt plates. There is a constant ballet of attendants as they refill glasses and produce dish after succulent dish. Pudding is produced at the table later on one of the Queen's many porcelain services. This opulent event comes to an end with desserts such as the fruit course, which is yet on another porcelain setting, accompanied with